Welcome, RPA champions. This is the RPA champion, and in today's video, we are going to be looking at the history of Blue Prism. So we're not just going to talk about the history of Blue Prism. We're going to answer some trivia, such as who coined the term RPA? Well, obviously it was Blue Prism. We're going to understand how they got from where they were to today's international company. We will also take a look at how they were formed, their founders' history, who their founders are. We will look at the major successes. We will look at their stock price, and we will do an analysis of their stock price and the market predictions for the future according to analysts and according to different sites. We will also look at their new accomplishments, and I will share in the end my personal very subjective opinion about the future of Blue Prism. I have been working with many years with Blue Prism. I am certified in different certifications that they offer, and I have a large experience with Blue Prism. Therefore, I believe that my personal subjective experience could be interesting for some. Now we're going to start things off and kick things off from this chart that shows a summary of the history of Blue Prism. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a very interesting deep dive into the history of Blue Prism. Therefore, I suggest you to sit back in your chair, grab a cup of tea, and let's get ready for this ride. So, Blue Prism was founded in 2001, it was formed by a group of process automation experts that developed a technology that could be used to improve the efficiency of financial institutions. So initially they were focused on back office activities and back office tasks in large financial industries. So it was founded by the two gentlemen. It was founded by Alastair Bathgate and David Moss. Now, let's take a look at these two gentlemen. So I have found their profile on LinkedIn. So this is Alistair. He has been with Blue Prism for the past 20 years and has quite some experience also in other companies. Now, this is David Moss, on the other hand. He is the current CTO of the company, and he has been with Blue Prism also for the past 20 years. I will share all of the links that I will be presenting during this presentation in the comments below. So if you want to see anything that I have showed, please feel free to visit the comments and find the link that you are most interested in. And also, this is a good time for me to jump in into the midpoint of this video and tell you to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. That would be a really good encouraging thing to do for you, so that I would feel encouraged to do more videos like this. Now, back to us and back to the story of Blue Prism. So we've seen that Blue Prism was created out of the need for a technology that would help financial institutions work in the back office. So Blue Prism was formed. It was formed with Alistair and Dave, who were the original co-founders. And another very interesting thing to say is that the term that we all know so well, robotic process automation, or RPA, Blue Prism has been credited for coining this term. Therefore, this is something that is accredited to Blue Prism. So we can see that through time in 2001, they were born out of a consulting company. They were giving consulting services. They created a product soon and co-founded a company. Once the company was co-founded, they also created an operating model on how they're going to deliver Blue Prism to financial institutions and to the different companies. Now, initially, it was not intended for it to live in the cloud and to have all of the different components and technologies that it has right now. Initially, it was just a tool that was supposed to do repetitive manual tasks installed on your own computer. A little bit like software testing tools were used to test different software that was built. Now, we are going to jump a little bit. They were successful in this market, especially because they were pioneering this market. And also after the different financial crashes that happened, there was a huge need from financial institutions in back office activities. Why? Because there were many new regulations and norms that were being put on financial institutions. Therefore, they had to produce a lot more documentation, a lot of more of that manual and repetitive documentation Therefore, this was an ideal use case for RPA. And this is how RPA was able to propagate amongst the financial industry and be adopted firstly in first person by the financial industry because of this need to create more reporting and be more compliant due to the financial crashes. Now we are going to catapult ourselves into 2016. Why 2016? Because this is it is a major success for Blue Prism. So from 2001 until 2016, Blue Prism has been gaining traction. They were until the early 2012-13, they were mainly the main competitor in the marketplace. They were the ones that were dominating the RPA space, also by having coined the term. They were the leader in the market. In 2006, something really great happened for them. They decided to IPO. So Blue Prism underwent an IPO in March of 2016. The company shares rose by 45% on the first day of trading, and this was a great success. And the shares have been rising ever since. Now, before we continue and we talk about the present and the most recent accomplishments of Blue Prism, I just want to go with you through this analysis of Blue Prism that I have found online. So this is an assessment of the stock price of Blue Prism, of their future, of their management. There is different things. Obviously, this is to be taken with a grain of salt. This is this has been provided by an external service. Therefore, we don't really know how accurate or how subjective or opinionated this is. Respected website that does provide a lot of good quality content. All right, so let's dive into Blue Prism and see what we can find that could be interesting. So right off the bat, we see that it has identified a couple of things that could be risky. So it's currently saying that the company is not going to be profitable for the next 3 years, and also that the shareholders have been diluted in the past year. Now, if you are a shareholder, that is not really good news. Now, if we continue and we see the price, the current price of the stock, we can see that it IPO at around £1.18, and right now the price has, So if we take a look at the price, so this is on the Prism ticker on the IM market. So they are quoted here at this price. Now with this, I will leave the link for this in the video so that you can take a look at this for yourself. You can see the different events that contributed to the variation in different price. We can also see that the price is currently overvalued and that the fair price should be relatively inferior to that. Now, we can also see that the earnings and revenue growth forecast is trending up, which is a good thing, and also the share price of the share price should be increasing in the following years according to this forecast. Now I just wanted to jump very quickly to the management part of the and ownership part. So here we have the main positions and the leadership team of Blue Prism, and here is an interesting detail, which is their ownership percent. Since this is a publicly traded company, this information needs to be public. Therefore, we can see that Conard Kingdon, who was originally working in Blue Prism before as CEO, has returned this year, meaning in 2020 on April, and became the new CEO of Blue Prism, taking that place from David Moss. So David Moss, until until most recently, until April of 2020, was the CEO, and Kingdon returned and has taken that place from him. Now we can also see that he has a very large percentage in the equity of Blue Prism. He is also the largest owner. If we take a look at also the institutional owners or top shareholders such as companies, we can see that the largest shareholder is HMI Capital Management with 5%. So this is an overview of Blue Prism share price. Now let's focus a little bit. We've talked about the past. Let's talk about the present now and the future. So for that, I've done this little research of Google Trends, and I've compared the search term Blue Prism UiPath Automation Anywhere and Power Automate, just to see how the term has been trending over the past 12 months. If we increase this and we make it maybe over the past 5 years, we can get a better idea of how it all started, meaning that we know that Blue Prism was leading RPA in until a certain point. They were the ones that coined the term RPA. They were the market leader for RPA, and we can see that here in 2017 they were still in front of Blue Prism. They were still in front of UiPath Automation Anywhere. Power Automate didn't even exist back in the day. It did exist, but it was not used. And then we can see that there was a steady but sure overtake of UiPath Blue Prism on a worldwide level, and we can see right now that Blue Prism is tending and trending slightly more up. This is due to the different decisions and changes that they decided to implement lately. So they've between 2018 and 2019 they purchased Totonomy. Totonomy was an RPA leader in the space of cloud RPA. They were providing cloud services, meaning AI services in the cloud with RPA in the cloud, all bundled together in the Totonomy workplace. Now Blue Prism bought Totonomy and decided to create a new product for the market, the Blue Prism robot that would be hosted on in the cloud, but also enhanced with all different capabilities such as chatbots, such as OCR engines, BPM tools, and so forth. All the bells and whistles that you would require to create end-to-end automations. So they purchased Totonomy. They completed the integration inside of their Blue Prism, meaning that initially they were still pushing it to clients as Totonomy, even though it was purchased by Blue Prism. They have fully integrated it into their suite. They have consolidated all the different technologies into different options that Blue Prism has for sales, and also they have integrated their new exchange portal, which has been beefed up with different new features and functionalities that make it very complete for creating end-to-end automation. And that's pretty much it. I would just also like to mention to you guys that Blue Prism was built on the Microsoft Net framework. And also another thing about Blue Prism company is about Blue Prism Ventures. So in 2021, Blue Prism launched a Blue Prism Ventures. This is their venture studio or investment studio, and this helps venture partners find collaboration opportunities within the field of software process robotic automation. And their first Blue Prism company venture is in South Korea, Blue Vision Korea, with GTP Plus Limited. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. This was a brief summary of Blue Prism. I wanted to highlight some of the main achievements that they went through over the years, some of the management that is managing the company, their share price, their analysis, their product and tools, and how they are relevant in the market. I have really enjoyed working with Blue Prism. It has been a great company. I have noticed many things that could have been done better, such as this is again my personal and subjective opinion. I believe that one of the main issues that Blue Prism had was to keep the software so closed in such a closed community and not creating a more open community like UiPath did. UiPath had a community version of their software. They were really building a community, asking for feedback from developers, from the community, and really created this sense of community. This is what was something that was lacking inside of Blue Prism. Why? Because if you were not affiliated with Blue Prism in somehow, or with a company that was working with Blue Prism, it would be impossible for you to learn Blue Prism. Therefore, the entry into the learning of Blue Prism was very high, was very difficult, because the technology wasn't provided for free. Right now, the technology is provided for a one month or 3 month learning basis. Therefore, if you go to the Blue Prism website, you can download their tool. And they also created a university for Blue Prism, where you can watch some interesting videos about how to create different things with Blue Prism. You can also check out my channel about Blue Prism. I have plenty of videos about how to get started with Blue Prism and how to create some basic automations. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I hope this was insightful. If you have any questions about what we have covered today, any questions, any observations, comments, or critiques, please feel free to leave them down in the messages below. I hope that you have enjoyed your cup of Yorkshire tea, and I will see you in the next video. Have a great day!